Good afternoon. My name is Andrew. I'm one of the reference librarians here at the Rancho Mirage Public Library. And on behalf of David Bryant and the rest of the staff, I'd like to welcome you this afternoon to what's sure to be a wonderful afternoon of music presented by Ken and his big band staff. We are indebted this afternoon for this performance to Jay Bartouche, who gave the library a very generous contribution. We're glad you're all here. We hope you enjoy the afternoon, and I'm going to turn this over to Ken, who will take it from here.
Well, let's see, that must be on. Thanks for being here with us today. Colin,
yes.
Just so I don't pull your berry over. That would be a disaster to pull his horn over. So that was Stompin' at the Savoy, our opening tune. That came from, that's actually the jacket from, does anybody remember LPs? 33 and a third. Yeah, well, that was the recording that Stan Kenton did live. It was called Stompin' at Newport. It was done right here in Newport, California, and it's Stompin' at the Savoy. We're going to move on now to our next tune, and let's see. What does that look like, guys? Maybe Dynaflow?
Oh,
Thank you for that. Dynaflow, a very popular tune. Stan Kenton recorded that, I think, in 1959. Although he recorded it several times, so if I'm wrong, just pick another date, I'll be right. Another tune that was popular was It Might As Well Be Spring. Thank you. Jeez, I forgot I put that in there. I think that's from the last show. Well, are you? Okay. Here was a famous album that Stan did, and I don't remember. I looked this up, and honestly, I don't remember the year. But it was in, I believe, in the 70s. And I like these. Oh, by the way, we just got these charts in about 10 days ago. They're all brand new charts. We ordered them directly out of his library. And the band saw them for the first time at 2 o'clock today. So this is probably more fun for us than it is for you. Okay. Okay, Gary says no. Thank you. Okay, I have to say I'm shocked. This concert was originally scheduled for March, and then there was some scheduling problems and it got pushed into April. And for those of you that don't know, this parking lot that you parked out here is ultimately gonna get covered and have solar panels put over the entire whole parking lot. I knew you were gonna like that. It was scheduled for April. So we got canceled. And then it didn't happen. It's gonna happen. It didn't happen. And the library administration thought maybe we should just reschedule this concert, so that's why we're here today. Yeah, and Colin here, my wingman, says, and that's why you're here today. But at any rate, we're really happy because doing a Saturday afternoon concert when we generally, the library here doesn't generally do that, and it's late in the season and in the seasoning also. And a lot of people have gone to their summer homes. We thought maybe that the band would outnumber the audience. Give yourself a round of applause for being here. Thank you very much. Okay, I gotta set up this next tune, and I'm gonna do it real quick, like do that. This was from Kenton's 1976 album. Well, it says that, doesn't it? Kenton 76. This was a tune that Stan Kenton himself played. And to tell you a little bit about this, how this came to be in this concert, so when I saw this, I had an idea. My co-partner, alto player, who also played Barry on that a couple pieces ago, Stan Kenton frequently used two Barrys instead of two altos in a Barry. At any rate, a fine musician, Colin here, has a son who, I guess you could say, just finished, I believe, his first year at Juilliard. On a full scholarship. And his name is Joel, and he flew in yesterday and got here at 1 o'clock this morning. And he's sitting at that piano right there. He said this was the closest he could get to looking like Stan. Anyway, we're gonna feature him on this next piece called Send In the Clowns. Thank you. As a parent, I can't think of another way to be more proud. Did anybody out here actually ever go to a Stan Kenton concert? Yeah. Stan was a guy of few words. He just played the music. And that's what we're going to do. And this next tune features a trombonist. Who's going to do this? So we'll see who stands up. Here's Maria. Thank you. did this, but I put two trombone solos back to back. Anyway, this comes back again to his road band in 1967. I was around in 1967, were you? I'm looking at a sea of either no hair or gray hair. Who's gonna do this one? Yeah, okay. You notice I'm not mentioning the guy's name, so I'm gonna introduce all of them to you a little bit later. After the show's over, for those that don't run out the back door because they've already been paid, you can meet them yourself personally. Here's the shadow of your smile.
Thank you.
Okay, this is another tune that Stan did off that same album. I actually went looking for another tune. I wanted Diamonds Are Forever because I was actually in that movie as an actor. And apparently Stan never did a chart on that tune. So the closest I could get to anything that was James Bond was Live and Let Die. So here it is. Well, we lived. Okay, now, we actually have some guys in the orchestra here that went to, the University of Redlands. If you went to that Redlands University, stand up, please. And if you played on this LP, stay standing. Now, I knew these guys went to the Redlands University. What I didn't know until today, that Jack had actually played with Stan on this recording, because it was recorded live at the University of Redlands.
I was only five.
He has his own band, like as many of these guys in his band do. But this isn't it. We have a lot of fun in this band and several of the others, and we just make this stuff up as we go. Sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. Anyway, here's That Rainy Day. We actually didn't play that one. We didn't have long enough time to rehearse everything. I think those guys did a good job. And you'll learn their names later. Yes. Who said that? I'm going to pick on you next. No, I won't. That's another guy's job. We actually have worked with that guy, Don Rickles. Yeah, you wouldn't have got away with that in his show. Okay, that's enough. So we're going to keep the tempo down a little bit. And this time I think we're going to go back to the piano. And we're going to feature Joel a little bit in here on a tune called... by the way, when I was growing up, this was my most favorite tune of all. That's why I picked it to be in this concert. I love Moonlight in Vermont. Anybody in here named Joe? No Joes in here? Because if Joe was here, we would jump for you. Thank you. Anybody heard of this tune? I have to apologize because I didn't bring my conga players or my bongo players or my tamale players. But we got a great drummer here, and he's going to cover all of them. I guess I don't want to shout. No, forget this. We would be remiss if we didn't thank both of these people aren't here today. The director, David Bryant, and principal librarian, Susan Cook. They're the ones responsible for scheduling us in here. If you like this concert, tell them on Monday. And of course, thank you, my sidekick, Dustin Ingham, right back there on that camera. He's our AV tech for this show. And now, trumpets, please stand. So we have Jeff Jarvis, Jostein Arflot, Dr. Jack Poster, and Gary Holopoff. And they've asked me to tell you that when you write the check, we put their name up there so you could make the spelling correct. And the trombones are right here. You've met them. They keep standing up all night long, but here they are again. Gary Toll, Greg Samuel, Brian Bergstrom, right back here on the big horn, Todd Humphrey. Sit down, guys. You've been up too much all night long. And the sax is the heart of the organization. Stand up, guys. Let's take a bow. Don Rice over here on tenor sax. Terry Fedoroff on tenor. Colin Wenhart, alto and barry. And Jeff Barish over there on the barry sax. Okay, and the soul of the organization, way back here on string bass, Jeff Stover. My main man right here on the drums, he used to be the youngest guy in the band, but Andy Frege. And now, the youngest guy in the band, Joel Wenhart, right down here. I don't know if this fella's here, but we want to say a very special thanks because this is the fella that underwrote this concert. So if you know this guy, for us, say thank you. And I think we're about running out of time. It's most of us have to go to the bathroom now. Everybody but Joel, he can hold it a little bit longer. So this is the final tune for the day. Thanks for being with us. If you liked it, again, please tell the library staff, and we'll be happy to come back and do it again. Oh, I almost forgot. So for the last, let's see, we were actually booked on this date maybe a month ago. So for the last 2 months, he's been sending me emails and says, let me play with my son. Would you mind if I had a solo with my son? I want to play with my son. Email at 4 or 5 of them a day. Can I play with my, can I have a solo? I want a solo. So he's going to get one out here. As a matter of fact, what we arranged is we opened up the chart a little bit in the middle, and we're going to let them both play. So here's intermission riff. Thank you. Thank you very much. That's all we've got. Thanks for being with us today. We really appreciate it. Thank you.